Hello everyone. In today's lecture, we'll be studying about the sixth lecture. We'll be studying about the highway pavement material. So we'll go in deep. So we'll see first what we're going to study in this class. Right? We're going to study about pavement material, advantages and disadvantages of pavement material, and construction of CC concrete. Road, right, and joints in cement concrete roads. So this construction of this cement concrete road is little bit different with respect to the flexible pavements, because this comes under the rigid pavement. So the rigid characteristics of the pavements are associated with the rigid or flexural strength or slab actions, right? Why we call it as a rigid? Because it has a rigid characteristics, right? And it has a flexural strength. What is meant by flexural strength? Which resist bending as well as deflections, right? So that is called as flexural. So the load is attributed for a wider area of subject soil, and rigid pavements are laid over with these slabs with steel reinforcement. Most commonly we go for a rigid pavement of RCC concrete with RCC with reinforcement, right? So these are the various components of the concrete pavement, right? One by one we'll go. You can see the lower portion, the orange color one, that is a subgrade, that is the lowermost part. Over that we have a base course or sub base course, you can call it. That is brown color. We may need this or we may not, depending upon the strength of the subgrade. Right? Depending upon the strength of the subgrade, we decide whether to go for base course or sub base course or not. Right? And the above we can see, these are concrete pavements, right? So concrete pavements are laid in some suitable width and thickness. We don't do it along the road like we do in the flexible pavement, go on with you. No, we are going to lay it in some sections so that we can have some gap between them. These are nothing but these are joints. Along the length of the joint you can see the perpendicular straight joint, you can see, right? That joint is called longitudinal joint. It is along the length, right? And perpendicular to the road, you can see those are called as transverse joint, right? And here you can see the bars, right? It is called as dovel bar. The bar which is along the length of the road is called as dovel bar. When it is across the road or it is transverse to the road, it is called as transverse joint, right? So it is called as transverse joint. These are the various parts of the RCC pavement, and it looks like this when it is laid in the. What we do is we lay it in different the sections. This is your first one. If you lay this, then you are going to lay this alternate one. Then you are going to lay this part and then this. It is called, we'll see how to laying is done in this all the coming class. Right? Next is advantages of rigid pavement. It lasts for more than 30 years compared to the lifespan of flexible pavements up to 10 years. Right? So it must longer. To the longer life, and it's durable, so we can go for rigid pavement in the case of highways. Right, we have our it lasts for more than 30 years. It's not only 30 years, it's more than 30 years. In long run, it is about half the cost to the installed maintenance, but the initial cost is somewhat high. What it is trying to say in this sentence is that if you construct with the concrete roads now, it will be very expensive. But for a long run, that cost will become a half of total maintenance if you consider with respect to the flexible payments. We don't have any maintenance works, right? We don't have any heavy maintenance works. So that cost you have been invested previously becomes half for such a long period. Rigid payments has an ability to bridge small imperfections in this upgrade. If there is any defects in this upgrade also, there is no problem. The rigid payment will look after it, right? Less maintenance cost and continuous fluent traffic, you can see. It is very hard and strong. It has a flexural strength also. So it has low maintenance cost because it is a concrete with a reinforcement. So it has low maintenance cost. High efficiency in terms of functionality means during the functional period of the rigid pavements, it is very high efficient. We'll see some of the disadvantages. These were the advantages. Now we'll see the disadvantages of highway pavement, concrete pavement. Initial cost is very high, right? As I said, initial cost is very high. The construction of such roads require a skilled supervision, because construction of such roads are not very easy. So you require skilled supervision. They cause very noise when the iron wheel traffic moves. If bullock carts moves, which has a steel plates, steel wheels, so it causes becomes very noisy, right? Next is they are liable to crack and wrap due to the temperature variations. They are liable to crack and wrap during the temperature variations. Concrete is a brittle material. It might expand and contract, due to which if this happens under a lot of continuous period, then there are chances of wrapping and texturing. They do not permit easy access to the subsoils when trenches are to be opened to locate water mains, sewers or electrical cables. Once you lay the rigid pavements, then you will not be able to dig any trenches for any other works. It is fixed. It becomes very difficult or hectic work to cut down. If you cut it down, then you have to replace the whole pavement. You can't replace some portion and then refix it. No. It causes glare due to the reflected sunlight. As I showed in the previous class, what is glare means and why it happens, right? Why it happens is in the cement concrete and why it doesn't happen on the flexible pavement, you know? Because the flexible pavements are of black color. So they absorb the light. They don't reflect the light. Right, and the cement concrete is of the grayish color, so they reflect the sunlight that puts glare into the eyes of the driver. The components of the concrete slab: you have a first layer is concrete slab, then you have subsoil, then you have subgrade. Right, the lowest portion or the lowermost part will be subgrade. The second lowermost part will be subbase, and the first top surface will be concrete slab, right? This is how it looks, right? You also have a drainage layer if you require. If the water is more, if there is a capillary action more, then you can go for a drainage layer, right? You have a subbase, may be stabilized or may not be as appropriate, as required, right? And you have a Portland cement concrete slab, right? Construction of cement concrete roads. Preparation of subgrade and subbases. No soft parts are present in the subgrid or base. You know how to do prepare the subbase and the base course, right? We have prepared in the previous three types of road, that is waterborne macadam road, right? Then we saw water mix macadam road and bituminous macadam road. So in the same case we will be doing here also, but no soft pots are present in the subgrids or base course. At least it should extend at least 30 centimeters on the either side of the width to be connected. Means what it is trying to say, if this is going to be road width, then the subgrid should be more than the concrete road. It should be 30 centimeters more on the both sides, right? This is your road width, right? So this will be your road width. So this will be your sub base. It will become your sub base. Right, this becomes the larger portion. It should be more than the width of the road. Subgrade is properly drained with minimum modulus of subgrade reaction is 2.52 kg per centimeter squared. Just remember this. Don't go into deep. This is for your high classes, right? The layer is kept moist when concrete is to be laid. As we do in the case of concrete slab or well columns, the side surfaces will be made moist. Water will be applied to it so that it doesn't absorb water from the, if it also absorbs from the water from the other surfaces, it will dry soon. So we keep the sides or the base to be moist before applying the cement concrete. Waterproof paper may be used when a CC is laid directly. If we are not applying the water to the surface, right, then you are going to put a waterproof papers before we construct the cement concrete road, right? Next is placing of forms. Steel or wooden forms are used for the sides, right? We want the thickness, we want the shape to be confined. So we will be providing at the sides. I will show you the images. Whatever images I have told, I will show at last all together once. Okay. A steel form of MS channel sections of required depth, they equal to the thickness of the pavement and the length of at least 30 meter, except on the curves less than 45 meters radius, except in the case of curves on the road, right? So the thickness will be as per the design of the concrete thickness slab, concrete slab thickness, and length should be minimum of at least 30 meters, right? Wooden forms are dressed on the sides and these have minimum base of 100 meters for a slab of thickness 20 centimeters. Right? The forms are generally jointed neatly and are set with the exactness to required to grade an element. The forms are laid very accurately and very precisely so that the alignment doesn't change. Right? Once the formwork is placed at the site, then you go for the mixing and batching of the concrete mixture. Proportionate mixture is being placed in the hopper of wave batching plant. Because the requirement is very huge, we will not be going for a small case, we are going for a large scale. So we will be having a plant here, RCC reinforced concrete mixer plant. Mixing plant will be here with the wave batch plant. All the batching of materials is done on the basis of one or more bag of cement. Weight of one bag of cement is 50 kg and unit weight is taken as 1440 kgs per meter cube. The mixing of concrete is done in the batch mixer so that the uniform distribution, uniform in color and homogeneous mix is obtained. Right? The batch of cement and fine aggregates and coarse aggregates is led together into a mixer, and water for mixing is introduced into a drum within the 15 seconds of mixing. Same thing what we do in the case of mixing of concrete, we have studied in the concrete technology as well as in the building materials. So how to mix the concrete, right? We are going to mix the cement, fine aggregates and coarse aggregate first, mix it properly, and then mix it with the water, pouring the water for 15 seconds, right? Transportation placing of concrete. The concrete is mixed in the quantity required for immediate use. We don't mix the concrete in excess. We prepare the concrete whatever is required for now, right? It should be seen that no segregations of the material results while transporting. While transporting from the place of preparing the concrete and the place of placing it, there should not be any segregation of the materials happening while transportation, right? Next one is, spreading is done uniformly, certain amount of redistribution is done with shovel. If it is not uniformly spreaded, then we properly uniform it by redistributing the concrete. Compaction and finishing. Surface of the pavement is compacted either by means of power driven finishing machine or by vibrating head screen, but nowadays we go for a power driven finishing machine because it helps us to complete the work at a faster rate, right? Areas where width of the slab is small, hand consolidation and finishing is available. Concrete is further compacted by longitudinal floats with the help of the parallel the carriageway and passed gradually from one side to another side. The slab surface is tested for its grade and levels in the straight edges. We check whether the thickness is the length, width is correct of the slab. Just before the concrete becomes hard, the surface is belted with the 2 plywood canvas belt. Broom finishing is done with the fiber brooms brush, particularly from the center line of the beam. So that's, there should be some friction given by the pavement to the road surface, right, to have some friction over the surface, right? Before concrete develops the initial set, the edges of the slabs are carefully finished with the edging tool. Right? The surface of pavement, this is curing we are talking about. Once we set it and we cure, surface of pavement is entirely covered with the burlap, cotton or jute mats prior to placing it on the saturated with the water, and wet side is placed on the pavement. You might have seen in your cities or during the smart city road construction works, nowadays they are going for a cement concrete road works. So in that case, you can see once the concrete is hardened after 24 hours, the jute bags are made, okay, are been laid over the wet jute bags are been laid over the concrete roads, and then for next 27 days the water has been sprinkled over that jute bag, right? And after 27 days, after removing the jute bag, the traffic is allowed over that road, right? Final curing is wet soil is exposed of the edge of the slab are banked with the soil bumps. It's like a shoulder we are going to provide. Blanket of sandy soil free from stone is placed. The soil is thoroughly kept saturated with the water for 14 days. Sometimes this is done, but not every time this might be done. But as per the procedure, you have to keep in mind that final curing is done with the soil, sandy soils without any stones for 14 days, right? This is how we do the initial curing. We provide the jute bags, and once jute bags tries to become dry, we sprinkle the water over it. Alternate bay method. How you are going to construct the concrete road? Because I said we can't go on laying the concrete road as we want, right? There is a method by which we can do it, right? So what we do, first we take this bay, we call it a small, we will take this section, we will pour the concrete and we will set it out. Once we place the concrete in this formwork, then we will place the concrete next in this form, in the alternate position. It is alternate, right? It is here, alternate here. Again, from here, we will go for here. Once this alternate series is over, right? This first bay, this is your second bay, this is your third bay, right? Once this is over, once we have completed with the construction of the alternate bays of first series, then we will go for second series. That is, this will become your first series, then afterwards this will become your second, and this will become your third one, right? This is how the construction will be done. This is your width of the road, and this is your length of the road. Then this is how we are going to first do one small section. Same size sections will be done in alternate opposite side, okay, right? And in the same, in the third case also. Then the remaining portions will be done, okay, once you complete the whole series. Once you complete this one side alternate lines, then you will do the remaining gaps which are meant to be filled up with the concrete, right? But the disadvantage of this type of method of pouring of concrete is you can't use the road after the construction, because first one alternate slab alternate bay method will require 15 to 21 days to solid. Once it is done, again the remaining portion will be done and that will be cured. So none of the side will be able to serve, right? Half of the side will not be able to be served in the case of alternate ways, right? You can't use the road half and half alternately same way. So for to remove this problem, what we have proposed is a second method, that is continuous bay method, right? So what we do, we go on making this small bays, right, like this. After the one first bay is completed, we go for second bay just below it, right? Again, next, third one, then again fourth one. Once this is completed, we'll go for the side here again, right? Till then this will be completed. So we'll allow the traffic to move in this portion, right? Because it is done, 21 days are over, we allow the traffic that, then till then we'll be completing this portion, second line. This will be our 5, 6, 7 and in between. Till then we allow the vehicles to move in this road here. Till then we will complete this. Once this is completed, we will allow fully. So only we go for continuous bay method. We don't go for alternate bay method, right? Now joints. Expansion joints, contraction joints, right, and expansion contraction wrapping of concrete results from the temperature and moisture change. As the temperature of the road and the of the rigid roads will vary, there might be expansion and contraction of the concrete. So to avoid that, so to overcome that temperature changes, stresses that is coming over the road, we provide a gap, we provide a joint which is filled with the epoxy resin or a bitumen, right? Mostly they go for a bitumen which is of a cheap and serves the purpose, so they go for a bitumen. The main big larger highway projects, we go for a for national highway projects, we go for epoxy resin, right? For that purpose we provide the concrete joints, right? Facilitate a break in the construction at the end of the work. So once we complete the day's work, we can end as that complete joint and we'll start the another next day. We'll start with the new part and we'll keep a gap so that we need not have to start from the same point, right? In the construction at the end of the day works or for unexpected interruptions of the progress. The joints become useful in the case when the work of the day is completed or if there is any unexpected interruption is there, then we can stop there and we can continue for the next time with the providing a joint. Right. Construction of pavements in the lanes for convenient width. Depending upon the width of the lanes, if there are multi lanes, it becomes very easy to construct lane by lane by continuous beam method, right? Next is, joints are discontinuous in the concrete pavement slabs, helps to release the stresses due to the temperature variation, subgrade moisture variations and shrinkage of concrete. So for all this, to overcome all those stresses due to the temperature, subgrade moisture variations and the shrinkage of concrete, we provide joints. Right? There are various types of joints depending upon the type of stresses developed. The first one is contraction. If these joints will be helpful when concrete tries to shrink, right, due to the shrinkage of concrete. So those joints will help us from releasing the stresses. Construction joints, whenever we stop for a day or for due to the unexpected interruptions, we provide a construction joint. Expansion joint and wrap joints are provided wherever we can't provide more than 5 or 6 meters of length of slab. So we have to go for expansion joints because there might be some expansions happening due to the variation of temperature, right? So those joints have been provided for that purposes. The contraction joints are provided along the transverse direction to take care of contraction of the slab due to the natural shrinkage. These are provided along the transverse direction. I showed you which is the expansion joint, which is the contraction joints, what are dowel bars, what are tie bars, where these are being used in the first slide only. Construction joints are provided whenever the construction work stops temporarily. And then joint direction could be either along traverse or either longitudinal direction, right? Expansion joints are provided along the transverse direction to allow the movements of concrete slab due to the temperature and subgrade moisture variation. Next is wrapping joint. Wrapping joints are provided along the length of the longitudinal directions to prevent wrapping of concrete slabs due to the variations and subgrade moisture variation, right? So this is what we studied. So how we place the cement concrete, what are the various layers of the cement concrete, we saw the various components of the cement concrete and we saw the joints in it, right? These are what we study in the concrete. It's not very easy to understand in one go. So if you go through your notes and as well as go to the videos for number of times, twice, you will understand the differences easily, right?